time to bring it on. You ready?
Let's do it. Let's do it.
This is Isabel, who says, I'm a female Christian teenager, and I've been wondering, how can I speak to my parents about dating? I do think I'm too young to date, and teen dating can sometimes lead to temptation because young teens don't always make the best decisions. I met a Christian guy who I do love, and we both want to wait until we're older and our parents give us the okay to date. Until then, how do you think I should talk to my parents about dating? What does the Bible say?
You know, this conversation should be coming from parents. How do I tell my teenager? You are very mature, and I just think that what you've got is wonderful. I think you ought to sit down very quietly with mother and dad. I don't know your relationship to them, and say, listen, I'm a Christian, and I think I should wait to marriage, but I've got a guy that I feel like I'm in love with, and I want to date him, but I don't want to do it until you folks feel good about it. I mean, it will blow your parents away. Trust me, with that conversation, they will be overwhelmed. If they're any good, they'll think, what a glorious daughter we've just raised.
Indeed.
That's beautiful. But that's what you say. Look, I want your permission. I want you to enter into this relationship. I want you to meet my friend and give me your opinion.
Okay, this is Stephen, Pat, who says, my mother died in 2011, leaving my inheritance in a trust to prevent me from giving 10% to my church. What can I do?
You take the money. I don't know how she can keep you from giving 10% if the money...
if he takes it out in increments, he can give 10%.
There'll be an income that'll come to you, and you can... But what she didn't... The trust says you can't take the corpus and cut it up where you give 10% of the corpus. You've got to keep that invested. But you'll get income, and so from that income, you can tithe and, you know, be happy. Mm-hmm. All right?
This is Bernice, who says, why does Pat see death as something bad? As a believer, isn't dying and going home to be with the Lord our final goal? Why is Pat saying to rebuke the angel of death when the angel of death takes us home to be with God?
There are times when the devil wants to take you prematurely. And that's what I was talking about, rebuking the angel of death when somebody the one I was thinking about, he was a father, he had five children, he was like 31 or 2 years old. Mm-hmm. And for a young father to be taken away from his children prematurely is not of God. But of course, when we get closer, I come to some funerals I preach, that's the going home of the saints. The saints of God rejoicing with the Lord. But a 32-year-old father with 5 children, I'd rather him stay around a little longer. But the rest of us, heaven is our home, absolutely.